I keep wanting to get to you, but news keeps dropping, so I must put you off for a few more days. What's up, guys? Blackscape here, and we have an unexpected announcement today. A brand new official Dragon Ball teaser has just dropped. Now, it has been a while since anything official has dropped from Dragon Ball that can give us some information on what the future of the series and the manga and everything is going to be, as well as the video games. And that is something that we have come to terms with as a Dragon Ball community. We have been in a drought of viable information that doesn't have a bunch of chefs in the kitchen working on it. Because if you really think about it, when it comes to Dragon Ball Super, even back in the day, when it came to going online and trying to find some information and spoilers, we really only had a few Twitter accounts that were basically translating everything for Dragon Ball, giving us the news, giving us the updates. But if it wasn't for that, we'd have to wait for the manga and the magazines to drop little tidbits on what the future of Dragon Ball is going to be. And so the information was all over the place, with a bunch of people integrating and describing it in whichever way they seem to understand said information. Well, now it looks like we are going to have a portal to give us all the factual Dragon Ball information, as well as news, and it seems like maybe even some of the history of Dragon Ball when it comes to not only the shows, the movies, but also the games, just on one site, and that is the Dragon Ball official site. The new teaser has just dropped, and it is, quite frankly, just a teaser of what is to come. It gives us a little bit of insight of what the UI is for the site itself, what it has to offer, and how it is going to reach a global audience. Because this one has something that takes a long time for us to get when it came to Dragon Ball spoilers, and that is translations. But with a click of a button, the Dragon Ball official site is going to be able to support 5 languages, including Japanese. So that really eases up exactly what the issue is when it comes to getting Dragon Ball from Japan, and that is a translations. A lot of accounts, a lot of websites, and a lot of YouTubers, they strictly work with the spoilers, or they solely work on spoilers. A lot of YouTube channels, they mainly focus on it, and without viable and accurate spoilers that are translated 100%, then they can come off kind of goofy when they are trying to announce things, but they don't have all the information. A lot of YouTubers, they want to be the first one to hit that news, but if the information is translated incorrectly, well, then you have a problem. But with this site, it does it for you. It's an official translation, and it seems to be doing it right off the cuff. So this honestly has me the most excited, because it puts everyone on an equal playing field. As long as you are the first one to go to this site, as long as you're the first one to jump in, you could actually get the news before other people in the past who had contacts that could translate the information for them. So evening out the playing field for me as a Dragon Ball YouTuber is very nice. But the main issue with this site is that a lot of people don't use sites very often to get their information. This isn't like the mid-2000s where you go on CartoonNetwork.com to figure out when the new episodes of Samurai Jack were going to drop. No, this isn't that. It is the age of huge social media presence and trending topics. That's essentially it. So if you're gonna be selling people on this website, you can't just have it be a website, and so they have to think outside the box. And one of those ways I can see them doing so is making an official Twitter account for the website, making an official YouTube account for the website, an Instagram account for the website. That would actually bolster up those numbers for people and the accessibility for them to jump in and actually kind of groove with the website. I'm sure if there was a Twitter account for this website, a lot of people would jump on right away. I know I would. Honestly, I think like the most accessible way for this website to be in everyone's pockets at the click of a button is an app. They need to work on an app for this website so everyone can get the information right in their pocket. They don't have to like search anything. They don't have to look at trending. They just click the Dragon Ball official site icon and boom, there you are. You're in the website. You get all the information. You click which region you're in. Boom, you have the most updated information on what Dragon Ball is. And that to me is one of the things they need to be focusing on right off the cuff. Now, lastly, I think that this is going to help them be more organized with the events of Dragon Ball. There is so much Dragon Ball everywhere. There are so many different types of genres and titles for Dragon Ball that really makes everything kind of confusing if you really look at it from a grand scale kind of thing, where you have Dragon Ball Fusions, Heroes, Xenoverse 2, Fighters, Kakarot, Super, GT. There are so many different Dragon Ball titles with their own separate universes and a lot of different things that get muddled, and maybe that could help them actually get a little bit more organized with timelines as well as video game timelines, even announcing video games. And honestly, maybe if they go this route, Toyotaro will have a nice easy setup where he can kind of look to see, oh yeah, that's right, they didn't use the Dragon Balls from Earth in the Moro arc, so they shouldn't be in Earth. Things like that, you know. But lastly, the one thing that I really want from this website is a fan page. A fan page where people around the world could send in fan art, fan comics, fan animations, fan gameplay, all sorts of fan stuff on there. And it could be a huge thing where they can promote a lot of different artists and a lot of different creators. That would be so cool. I know it is a long shot because like a company like Toei and Shueisha, they don't want fan anything. They don't want you to support fan anything. They want you to be only on the canon side of Dragon Ball or whatever they put out. So I know it's a long shot, but I think that it could really bring up a lot of interest, a lot more interest than normal in this site. So many people would be on it. If you had a login, you can go in there and send in some artwork and they can showcase it or promote it or put it on their page, whatever the case might be. I think that would be bringing the community together in such a wholesome way, because a larger Dragon Ball community is a fan-made community. A lot of people in the community, they do a lot of fan art, a lot of fan comics, and they love Dragon Ball in that sense. So anyway, guys, let me know in the comments below what you guys thought of this teaser. What would you like out of the Dragon Ball official site? And if you made it to this point in the video, you are now part of the hashtag #EndOfVideoSquad. Thank you guys so much for all your support. Make sure to drop your comment with that hashtag for a chance to be featured in my next video. Today, I'm going to be responding to Ayo the Ace. Now, this guy didn't put hashtag #EndOfVideoSquad, but I'm going to take a mulligan here and say that he watched most of the video. But he put, damn, I can see people comparing Goku to Mr. Incredible. I just thought that was funny. Don't be throwing shade at Mr. Incredible, okay? I watched both those movies, and he's rather strong. Plus, he's a family guy, and I'm a family guy, so yeah. Don't be throwing shade on Mr. Incredible, alright? Anyway, thank you so much for your comment, Ayo. This is going to be Blackscape, signing off. Take care, guys.
Subscribe for more content.